house in southern Spain with only bed quilts for soundproofing. And if you listen carefully, you'll see that the natural background sounds contribute to the album's raw style.
I mean, we were recording the album in Marbella. We were down there for the best part of 9 months, and I think it rained for 3 days. And one time, and there was a drought. I mean, it was real, one of the days it did rain, and it was really heavy. We put a microphone out the window and recorded it, and we stuck it on the front of one of the songs. On another song, we were recording the acoustic guitars outside at midnight. We actually sat in the garden with microphones out there, and there's dogs barking and cars going past.
And candles and incense and all that. It was great.
And, you know, if you listen to the tracks, you can actually hear all this stuff. And we left it on, you know, because it was just part of the vibe.
Def Leppard's new single, Slang, represents a broadening of the band's musical horizons. And not surprisingly, they're keen to point out the differences between Slang and their previous material.
I can see, you know, maybe as an instant analogy, people will say, oh, Slang sounds like Sugar, or, you know, I Want to Touch You, or Let's Get Rocked, or something, because it's got that chanty. If you actually listen to it, it's a hip-hop drum beat. Sonically, the sounds are vastly different. Sab's bass is totally different sound. Rick's drums are totally acoustic. It's a real organic sound. It's not got that big 80s production thing. Just the arrangement of the song and the poppiness of it, because it's a pop song, really.